According to a lawyer, Besigye or Kyagulanyi cannot remove His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. This comes after 7th of October 2021, a day to Uganda's 59th independence. Two events happened in relation to Dr. Kizza Besigye Kifefe and Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu, who are both former presidential candidates in Museveni Rogue elections. Hello, welcome, and thanks for joining us live on PROJOURN Media TV. That brings the latest news and the latest updates in the country and across the world. But let's take more look into some of these details. At LDC Court, His Worship Alule Augustine Koma was presiding over a case of obtaining registration into Makerere University by false pretense, where the accused Kyagulanyi had skipped court, leading to a finding that counsel for the accused submitted that the absence of the accused is because he was not served and he found out this ridiculous and not true. So Kyagulanyi was found to be a dishonest man, according to the lawyer. And at Mengo, Besigye was elected chairman of People's Front for Transition, but no one knows how these elections were organized, who competed with who, among others. This is no different from the way Kyagulanyi was named president of his acquired National Unit Platform Party Political, and they both preach democracy but rise to opposition powers through means which do not amount to democracy. In Daily Monitor, that was on 11th of November 2013, carried a headline saying Besigye won't contest in 2016, in which he told Herbert Ziwa that, first of all, as a person, he will not offer himself in an election organized by the dictatorship. Just like Honorable Robert Kyagulanyi promised not to make a political party but later acquired one, Besigye indeed stood in 2016 elections, was sworn in, and formed the People's Government. Therefore, rely on what they both say at your own risk. He said, if you were to rely on what they say, rely on them at your own risk, according to the lawyer. And they both have a background of working with a dictator for several reasons. And in his youthful age, Besigye chose a violent route of challenging the then Rogi Obote regime in 1981, through participating at the high level in the Museveni war that ended in 1986, killing close to a million Ugandans. Until 1999, he worked tirelessly to entrench Museveni fascism through building a countrywide network of public servants, serving individual Museveni interests and making them to be part of Museveni political outfit of movement system. And these are now the resident district commissioners, those are RDCs. And on the other hand, in his search for wealth, Kyagulanyi closely worked with the dictator, ranging from meeting his close family, ranging from ministers and servants, including making a U-turn on Kampala Capital City Authority, illegalities perpetrated by Executive Director Jennifer Musisi, by attending a high-billed carnival despite his song against them. He recently said that he made Saleh to invite him to his concert, and on that same day, he met Dr. Kizza Besigye and he came through. In turn, he got rich, became untouchable despite being the biggest drug addict Uganda has ever had, spoiling many young people through false hopes that abusing drugs will make them shine like Kyagulanyi, leading them into insanity and lunacy. And a big question lingering in his mind as the lawyer is whether any of these two beneficiaries of the regime can successfully lead to its complete dismantling, as the majority who are opposed to it have never benefited from it, aspire. A greater part of his mind says no. And those are the two people whose teams have been exchanging sharp words, abuses, name it, for the past 10 days, yet indeed, they are both similar in character and action. He said the Luganda word, though, that is going to be a bit hard for me, where he said, where two elephants fight, it is the grass which suffers. And many young people, most of whom have never benefited from the regime, are fighting tooth and nail on either side of these elephants. The lawyer continued saying that this fight is making it clearer that maybe for more opposition under Museveni is profitable, going by the energy and resources injected in by its side. And fellow citizens, it does not take a politician to dislodge a dictatorship. The men and women who dislodged the French monarch in 1789 were not politicians. In Zanzibar, it took a non-citizen, Okello, a casual lawyer, to dislodge the dictatorship. Let each one of us concentrate on doing what is possible to overcome the junta, as opposed to taking sides with those fighting for opposition supremacy. The real opposition is the people of Uganda. These are the words from lawyer and civically active Ugandan by the names of Alule. Well, that is it for now. Thanks for watching ProJourn Media TV. We'll keep on updating with more of this. Just kindly do one thing, subscribe, turn on the notification button. All these updates will come to you in time. Once again, thanks for watching ProJourn Media TV.